Good morning, students. Welcome again. Today we will discuss more about Python revision. Today's topic is variables and data types. Now we are here discussing some bare bone of a Python program. Bare bone means just the basic and essential requirements or the things of a Python program. See here, program is given here, okay, and what is there here, we know that with the symbol hash it starts a comment. This is comment, and when we write def function, def is a keyword, okay, to start a new function. Function, what is function? If you don't know now, don't bother, we will we will discuss it later. But here you should know that a function is a small program within a large program. It is a small program within a large program which must be called to get executed. It won't automatically execute it. We have to call in the program, other part of the program, to get executed these statements. Okay. See, function starts with def function and some name is there, some data details are there here. Then we have to give colon symbol and then some statements. See here, we started all the statements after some gap here. This is known as indentation. Okay, this is known as indentation, and the whole complete block, it is known as the complete block. From here to here, it is a block, and this block is known as function. Okay, each and every block should have indentation, then only it is treated as a block. And a block is created to group some statements, and these statements are executed one by one to all the block. Okay, now these are the statements or the expression, it is called expression. Okay. This is the print statement to display something. We already know these things. Okay, this here we have called the function. Here, this statement we have written. Here we call this function. This function is just called here. And again one print statement, and again we have called the same function. A function can be called more than one time, and it is created for that purpose only, so that we can call the function more and more time. Whenever we require, we can call the function and get executed and do the actions, do the perform. Okay, so, these are the parts of the program. Okay, so, some program may have not having all these parts of the program, but these are the essential parts which makes a program in Python language. A Python language program should have comments, functions, indentation to start a block, expression to do some calculation work, and statements to get output or to execute some statement or give the instructions to the computer. These are the parts. Now here we have combined all the parts here. See, a Python program contains the following components. Program may have not all the components, but these components makes a Python program. First is expression, okay, to do some work. Statements to statements are the instructions for the computer. Comments are the readable words or the readable sentences or information written for the program. Functions are the block of a set of statements to get executed when it is called. And blocks and indentation. Blocks and indentation means to group a list of statements, we have to make block, and indentation to make a block of statements. Statements should be indented. Okay, some gaps would be given. Now next page. Here we again put the same thing, just with the explanation. Expression. What is expression? Which is evaluated and produce results. Say for example, 20 plus 4 is an expression. Okay. Statement. Statement means the instruction for the computer. Here we have assigned 20 to A, and we have given print statement. Okay, these are the statements. These are the basic elements of a Python program, bare bone of a Python program. Comments, which is readable for programmer but ignored by the Python interpreter. Okay, it is ignored. Ignored means they don't while executing the Python program, these comments are left or skipped. These are not read by the Python interpreter or not get executed or do nothing. Just it is a message for us, for the programmer, for the user of the program. Okay. Listen, we can give comments in two types. First, single line comment, and next, multi line comments. Single line comments must begin with hash symbol. Okay, hash symbol. And multi line comment, which is known as doc string. Either we can write multiple line beginning with hash symbol, each line should have hash symbol, or we can use triple coded multiple line, triple coded, triple quotation mark we can give at the starting of the state of the message or the comment, and at the end of the message or the comment. Okay, this whole text is termed as comment. Okay, this whole text starting with triple quotes and ending with triple quotes, we can use either single quote or double quote. Okay, three times we have to put. Then this complete words, and we can go to multiple lines to write all the message or the comment. This is known as multi-line comment. We can give anywhere in our program, and these are the message which must be ignored by the Python interpreter. It is only for user to read and know about the program. Now come to function, the fourth part of the Python program. Function. What is function? A code that has some name and it can be reused. Say for example, we have used key arg function in our program. It is a pro function which must be called to execute, to get executed. It contains some codes. It contains some instructions. It contains some commands. Okay, to get executed when it is called. Now, the fifth one is, this one is would be block and indentation. Block and indentation. Block means a group of a statement is block, and indentation at same level create a block. Okay, to make a program or the statements, list of statements in a block, we should indent in same level. Okay, same level we can indent. Then all these statements will come to a block. See, variables. Variables are the most necessary element in a program. What is variable is a name given to a memory location. A variable can consider as a container which holds value. Python is a type infer language. That means you don't need to specify the data type of a variable. Python automatically gets variable data type depending on the value assigned to the variable. To create a variable in Python language, it is very very simple. Just assign a value to a variable. A variable, what is variable? Variable is A, B, C, D, E, F, nothing. These are the variable names, and variables must follow the rules of identifiers. Identifier is the second component of a token. Okay, in Python language, we must know about these things. There's it should start with letters or underscore, and it can contain more number of letters, and those things we have to create. What here, if we give, suppose here we have given a equals to 23, what it will do, it will in the memory it creates a box. Okay, box where it can hold the number, the value 23 will be hold here. Okay, and this box is named as a. Okay, whenever letter we call letter a, the variable a, it will give the value, whatever the value is stored in that box, it will give the value. Suppose we have created two variables here, b equals to 6.2, it will again create another box with the value 6.2 inside it. And when we call here we are calling a plus b. Okay, a plus b, then the value of a 23 will come, and the value of b 6.2 will come, and it will add. Here operator plus is given, it will add, and when it will add, it will give some results. After counting, what will be the result? 29.2. now this will become, and this 29.2 will be stored in a box again in sum with the name sum in somewhere in the memory. Okay, and then print, here we have given the print sum. What will happen? The value of the variable sum will be printed, that will be the 29.2. okay, understood? So see here, multiple assignments. Come to multiple assignments. Multiple assignment means at the same time we can create in a single line, we can create so many variables with the same value. It is possible. Okay, and if we want to give different values to different variables, again we can do the same thing in a single line using the statement. Here see, a equals to b equals to c equals to 1. What will happen here? It will create three variables, a, b and c, with the value 1. And again we have given the some other statement here, a comma b equals to 1 comma 2. What will happen here? It will create two variables, a and b, with the value 1 for a and 2 for b. Okay, 2 for b means the respective value will be stored in the respective variables. It will create two variable with the value 1 and 2. And here see what we have done, we are here creating a and b, two value with the value of previous variable, that is a and b. But we have swapped b, first we have written b then a. What it will do, it will swap the variables of a and b. A will become 2 and b will become 1. If we print here, it will display a equals to 2 and b equals to 1. Okay, come to next. Now dynamic typing. Dynamic typing means what it means, that as we know that variables are created when we assign a value to that variable. When we assign a value to a variable is created. Say for example, a equals to 10 we have given, it will create the variable a. Okay, now if in the letter stage we have assigned some different value, a equals to, suppose we have given within quotation some different variables. Suppose here we have given some Python, suppose the word Python. First time we have assigned the value, numeric value to the variable, and next time we have assigned the string value to that variable. Then here most languages other than Python language, most language gives error messages, but in Python language it is acceptable. It is acceptable. There is no problem. No, there is no harm. There is no error. Okay, it will do as it is instructed. It means it will assign, next time it will assign the value Python to the variable. Here x equals to 25, and next time we have defined x equals to Python. There is no problem, we can do these things. It is known as this feature is known as dynamic typing, and this feature is only available in Python language. Okay, but we should take care of these things, that when we assign a string, then we cannot do any arithmetic calculation on that variable, because it is a string. It become a string, then we cannot divide x by 5. Okay, it will give errors. We should take care of these things. So what we have learned about dynamic typing: a variable pointing to a value of a certain type can be made to point to a value or object of different type. This is called dynamic typing. Now come to variables scope means its lifetime. Some variables have a lifetime, some variable have a visibility means we can see in certain areas of certain areas in the program. Here we have suppose, what is local variable? Here we have created a function fun, named fun function, actually it is, and here we have defined a variable x equals to 8, and when again printed the value, that display the value of x. What happened when we call this function? It will display the value 8 automatically. But what to call a function, we should give name of the function. Here we are calling the function with this statement, it will call these statements, okay, and it will display the value 8. But this but the statement here, print x, we have given. Now see, it will give error, it will be shown error. Because why it will happen? Because the variable x is defined within the function and it is local to this function, and this variable is not available here in the main function. This is the main function statement, here it is not available. To solve this problem, what we have to do, we have to make the variable global. To make the variable global, we have to define that variable at the top of the statement. What we have done here at the front means at the starting place, we have defined x equals to 8. Now this variable will become global variable, and what will happen, it will be available within the block also, within the local also, and also in the global. Global variables is available everywhere. Okay, now this program will give no error, and it will, wherever we print the statement, give the print statement to display the value of x, it will display 8. It will display 2 times 8. This is the output. Now problem solved. Now come to next statement. We already know what is print statement. Now here we have to know about input statement. Input statement, suppose we need to execute a program, and while executing the program we want some value to be given by the user during execution of the program, then what we have to do, we have to use input function. Input function is used to take to get input from the user while executing the program, and it is the built-in function. It is already available in the program, just we have to give the input function. What is the syntax? We have to give here variable name, then equals to sign, then input function, and then a message here within the double quotation or single quotation mark. We have to give message here. Now see, input function always return a string type value. Okay, string type value means we cannot do any calculation work on that variable, on that data. Then what we have to do is, suppose names are a string type, address is a string type, okay, these are the string variables. So when we need to input name, input address, then we can give input statement. It is also, we can use input function to get numeric values also, but we have to do it some with technique. What is the technique we have to give here? There are two functions available in Python language, two functions for numeric type. That is, one is int function and second one is float function. this function can be used for to get can be used to get numeric values from the input function. Just we have what we have to do, we have to write first input int function, and then within int function we have to call input function. Then what will happen? First the innermost statement will be executed and it will get the value and we have to type some number here. As and when we type the number, this number will be converted. This will number first it will take the number as a string, and then it will be converted to int function. Due to int function, it will convert the value as integer number, numeric number, which can be recognized by the Python language, and those number will be stored in the variable. Now this variable is pure numeric variable, and we can do calculation on that variable. Similarly, we can use float if we want. Integer number don't take decimal places values. If we want decimal places value, then we have to need to change from int to float. Print function we have again here explained. Here we have put some syntax also. In Python it is used to print output on the screen. The syntax is just print, give print, within bracket we can give expression and variable. There are so many ways to use print from print function. First we have given just the value 122 and it will give the same output. If here we have given within quotation mark hello India, it will give the output hello India. If here we have given expression means some calculation, then what will it do? It will calculate first, do the calculation first, then the result will be displayed. Now come to data types. What are data types? Data types we already know, we have discussed earlier, but not given the names data type. Now we understood, we will understand here. Most of the computer programming language support data type, variables, operators and expressions like fundamentals or basics or the essential components of the language. Python also supports these data types. What are data types? Data types specify which type of value a variable can store. The type function is used to determine the variable's type in function Python language. Okay, data type, what is? There are so many types of data. There are numeric data, boolean data, tuple, dictionary, string, list, set, so many types of data. To store numbers, number data type is available. To store boolean means true or false value. Tuple is a list of values, list of more than one value. Okay, and dictionary contains more than one value also, in combination with value and pair. A string is just double quotation mark or single quotation mark. We put any message or anything that will become a string. And list is also a type of tuple. It can contain a list of values. And set is also a type of dictionary, but it won't store data in pairs of value and value and subject and value. Now come to one by one we will discuss here. Numbers in Python, it is used to store numeric values. Python has three numeric types: integer, floating point numbers and complex numbers. Integers means those numbers which do not have any decimal places. It can be negative or positive number or zero number with no decimal places. Integers in Python are of three types. Unlimited size. Here we have stored 100 to A and minus 100 to B. Now we can print statement A and B, and it will give the output like this. Okay, now floating point numbers means those numbers having the decimal places. These are known as real numbers. It can also be positive or negative numbers, and it can have decimal places. Now here two variables created, A and D. A is stored 101.2 and 2.3 into 3. Here we have done some calculation. Then what will be the output? If we display it, then this will be the output. In the Python language, what has happened, to create any type of variable, just we have to assign that type of value to that variable, then variable automatically become the type, that type of variable. Suppose sometimes we need to check which type of variable this becomes, because dynamic typing is a feature is available in Python language, then we can use a function, type function here, to check what type of data it contains, or what type of function, what type of variable this is. Now, in Python language, we can also assign complex numbers. Complex numbers are those numbers which comes in a combination with real numbers and imaginary numbers. Okay, this complex numbers comes in the form of x plus yj. X plus yj, here x and y, x is real part and y is imaginary part, and these are numeric numbers. Numbers should be there. Suppose we have assigned a equals to complex 5, then what will happen if we print a? It will display here, it will print a, it will display 5 plus 0j. It automatically converted to complex number because complex function is called. Okay, now again we have called the function, complex function, and here what we have done, two values we have provided, then it will become, it will automatically take the first value as the value of x, and 23, and the second value will be taken as the value of y. Then this, when we print, then what will happen, it will display the value as like this. Okay, sometimes we don't need to call this complex function also. We can directly write like this, c equals to 4 plus, okay, 2j. We can write like this also, it will be acceptable to make any variable as complex variable. Now come to a string, we already know each and every string. A string is what is, first of all, a string is a sequence of characters. In Python we can create a string using single quotes or double quotes, both are same in Python language. Here are the examples of strings, and we already see all these things. So just assign this strings to a variable, and that variable will become a string type variable. Now boolean is a special type of data in Python language. What will happen, boolean means two value. The what are those two values? Two values are false and true. Okay, we can assign any variable to any variable as false or true, that variable will become boolean variable. Boolean variable are also known as plain integer. Plain integer means boolean values false and true are behaves like 0 and 1 in Python language. That's why sometimes boolean is also termed as integer numbers. Okay, to get boolean equivalent 0 and 1, we have to type bool bool, and within bracket 0 it will give false. Okay, it will give false value, and if we one type bool equals to 1, then it will give true value. Okay, just we can assign like this. Suppose we want to check y equals to true, we can write like this, true. One most important thing here we have to know here, that the variable that the value true or false must start with capital letters, okay, you must know this. If you type a small letter, then it will become a string type, or may give some errors also. Here list is list in the other type of data type in Python language is list. List is nothing but it is a list of comma separated values, and any data can be stored in with square brackets. These are the examples. Okay, tuple in Python, tuple is similar to list. In place of square brackets, we have to put parenthesis. Parenthesis means a small bracket. Both are okay. One major difference is also there. List is mutable type, and tuple is immutable type. And later we will know what is mutable type and immutable type. Okay, here know that it is it should be known that immutable Python objects means you cannot modify the contents of the tuple once it is assigned. We will later discuss it later. Now see here, sets in Python means it is an unordered collection of unique values and immutable values cannot be modified. Items set must be given within curly braces. Okay, within curly braces separated by comma. It should be unique. Unordered connection. Unordered means can give any value at the time. Level list, see, come here. See, say in Python, immutable type. Okay, it is immutable type and it is unordered and must be unique. See, we have stored here 22 and again 22 two times, but when we display the value 22 will be displayed only once. Okay, it takes unique values. This is the merit of this set data type in Python. Now come to dictionary. Dictionary is also like set, but it takes values in pairs. Pairs, what it consists, a key and a value. Okay, see here, two values are here, this one value and this second value with the name of DICT dict. Okay, here subject and computer science. Here subject is known as key, this is key, and okay, it is key and it is known as the value of that key. Again here this is key and this is the value. Two values are there in pairs. Now when we display, the print statement is capable to display this dictionary type also, and it will display like this. Okay, now here we should know mutable and immutable types. Mutable types are those values which can be changed in place, which values can be changed in place, and immutable types are those which cannot be changed their values in place. Mutable types are lists, dictionaries and sets. Okay, these three data types are available in Python language, which are mutable types. Those are list, dictionary and set. Okay, here see, we have stored three values, 2, 4, 6, and at the position, one position, we have changed the value 4 to 20. Okay, 4 to 20. Then when we display this variable x, it will display like this. It is changed. Now immutable type, what it do not change their values in place. These data types are integers, floating point numbers, booleans, tuples, strings and sets. Strings are, those are immutable data types and we cannot change their values. Here x equals to 2, 4, 6, again we have given to change the value 4 with the 20 value at the first position, because it starts with 0, then it will show the errors message. Okay, now we have understood. If you have any doubt, you can ask anytime. Now these are the assignments which you have to do. Thank you for now.